This is Eva. Eva's a 320-pound Atlantic bottlenose dolphin. This is Eva and I on our first date. We've subsequently had a second date. People have often asked me, what's it like to kiss a dolphin? Well, they do say the dolphins are the animals that are most like men, and I have to tell you, that's true. It's been months. She hasn't called me yet. You'll get that one later. Don't worry. So how does this happen? First off, dolphins don't do this in the wild, do they? No, it happens because there's a lady right up over here on the top. Her name is Dawn. Dawn is the trainer, if you will. And when I asked Dawn, how do you get Eva to do this sort of thing? The easy answer would, of course, be fish. Fish being the currency of dolphin. And we think that, you know, if we just give people some more reward, they'll deliver better service. It's not the way it works. Dawn told me, says, the dolphins basically know. If I do the minimum expectation, I get fed. It's pretty much the way with us too, right? You do the minimum, we're going to get fed. But that doesn't make us those sort of service stars that are out there. So I asked Dawn, how does it work? And she said, Randy, we spend about half of our time working on the performance, working on the task, if you will. We spend the other half of our time with the dolphins working on the relationships. So here's the question for you and I as we go out and start creating those sorts of experiences that people remember and take pictures of and sell. How much time are we spending building relationships? And I know that many of the people that you work with are people who are not in this building. And so you're going to have to be much more intentional about that. You're going to have to go out and you're going to have to think, what do I do in the email? What do I do in that 5-minute phone call? What do I do when I have that opportunity to interact? What do I do to build that relationship? Because here's the way it works. It works this way in all relationships. It starts with a transaction, which goes into a relationship, which goes to a partnership. That's the way it works. Transactions feed relationships, which become partnerships. I was doing a presentation up in Washington, D.C. some months ago, and I showed the picture of Eva, and right about the time I showed that, there was a gentleman right over here, and as soon as I showed the picture of Eva, he started jumped up and down. I mean, he just got really excited. Right, in fact, sir, with the goatee, right about where you are, if you could just kind of jump up and down. Okay. Never mind. But as soon as the presentation was over, he comes running up to me and he said, I guess you noticed that I got excited when you showed the picture of the dolphin. And I'm like, buddy, people in the next county knew you were excited. He said, let me explain. And he handed me his card and he said, I'm Jay Sweeney. I am president of Dolphin Quest. Eva is my dolphin. I said, well, I hope you don't mind me sharing the story. And he said, no, I loved it. I said, good, because I pretty much put it in my last book as well. And he actually bought a copy of the book, had me autograph it to Eva, and last time I was there, I think she was about halfway through. Not really, I just said that to make sure you were listening. But he said, let me tell you the rest of the story about Eva. This photo, she's 32 years old. Wears it pretty well, doesn't she? So this is, and then he said, this is the third program like this that Eva has been in her life. Third dolphin experience program. And the first thought that came to my mind is, I'm sure the exact thought that came to yours. I didn't realize there was a free agency program for dolphins. I said, is that normal? He said, no. Most dolphins, they grow up, they live, they're born, they die all in the same program. I said, well, what happened? He said, well, basically, Eva was fired from her previous two programs because she was a poor performer with a bad attitude. Now, I'd never heard of dolphins being fired from war. I'd seen a couple of sharks promoted. Never dolphins fired. But then I started to think, why is that? And Jay told me, that stuff you said about the relationships growing into partnerships, that's true. Think of that customer that you deal with every single day that when you see their number come up on the telephone, you're thinking, man, I just was hoping I wouldn't have to talk to them today. That's the person you start building that relationship with right now. That's that person that you think is the poor performer. That's who you start. He said once Eva figured it out that this, we were really concerned about her success, everything else got so much easier. That's the power of the partnership.